Hello everybody and welcome back to Chasing Away 2017. Well, a little message we got, it says, morning driver, you'll need to let the Paddington to Penzance service pass before entering Lowestoft. Yes, we are on the China Clay Line again. Back to it. And hopefully we'll have much more better success than we did last time we did the China Clay Line. but let's have a quick look on the F1. So we're going to be... Today we're going to take a passenger service. We're going to be... Today, task is to call at all stations between Lowestoft and Bugle. On arrival at Bugle, you will be relieved, as another driver will continue the service to Nuki. So we're calling at Lowestoft, Par, Luxley, and in Bugle at the end. I probably got them all wrong. Most of those names are all completely wrong. Right, let's put the put this version in. Let's put a 47 going past. Get the sound of the horn as it goes by. Right, so we've got to wait for this to go by. It's quite weird that we're on a 47 and a two-car service. You do feel like this should be like a DMU service, like even a first generation DMU, just sat here waiting to go along. That'd be good. Right, now that's clear to this. Take the brakes off. Let's put a little bit of acceleration. Let's roll up to that red light now. Or the red signal, I should say. Because that's what it cleared most of those signals then. Yep, there we go. So let's speed on up into the platforms. Make our way on this passenger service along the China Clay Line. So we're going to go along bits of the route that we didn't do before, and of course hopefully this time we won't do what our famous my famous video in 2016, Train Simulator 2016, and well, go for a red light. Start putting the brakes on. HST coming the other way. Stopping as well. Expect that to be flying through, really. Seemingly in wrong formation now. First class is in the rear. Oh, it is flying through. Just much slower. Well, that's gone by. Nice bit of AI traffic. Pro-typical of the era. Now we just wait for the... There we go, there's the bonus. We haven't got the signal though, so we have to wait here for a sec. Get the signal. Another red signal we have to wait for. Very typical of our little runs. I should say, no, I say updates lately. I don't know if most of you, any of you lot noticed, there's new videos coming out on Monday of a new game, Motorsport Manager. So if anyone here that watches that and quite likes their motorsport and everything, especially the Formula 1, that's what I'm doing at the moment on there, pop over and look at that video. Yeah, it's a very good game. It's a game I got bought in November for my birthday. To be fair, it's a game that you'll have a lot of fun, driving. Not driving, a lot of fun to doing, like managing the team and everything. It's really interesting, very good game to play. And yes, it's quite a long season we've got ahead of us that we'll be doing. I think it doesn't finish till our calendar. We'll be playing the game till for 16 days. 16 races we have. So yeah, there'd be 16 parts of the video when it's gone. Anyway, just going along saying that we got the token, we got the peg now, so we can move on along this line. Accelerate hard out. We have two coaches. Light low for this train. Anyway, let's slow the throttle down because we're coming up to the speed limit. Even if we're going uphill, like a 1 in 71, this is nothing to this engine. Really, it's quite light. Downhill. Let the gradients take us. Now we're going to be a minute late to par, looking at the thing recently. Come on, let's get up to the 60. There we go. Let's try and claw some of that time back. Row along down, right, AWS, green light, so obviously we're clear to go straight into power platform 3. Another train going past the other way. Right, start putting a bit of braking force on, because if we see a 60's coming up, in a bit go to 10, that's crossing, but we want to slow us down a little just so we can not have to harshly brake for the signals coming for that crossover. A bit more braking. Right, because the 10's coming up now, so a bit more braking force now. Lewis down ready for the 10. So we don't want to break the speed limit. It's something we don't want to do, of course, as always. We're in career mode, so it will penalise us heavily if we break the speed limit. Look here. That was quite good. So the speed up, car's going to signal, just if any of you noticed, in the corner. Crossover on the points. So that was an easy run to part. We did that last time though when I went wrong and jumped a red signal though. It was only a bit further down here when I went for the red signal. I didn't know which way I had to go. I forgot I needed to go backwards for some. But it did take like request accepted, didn't it, to pass. It was a bit of a weird one. Get us on time if we break hard. Heavy. Yep. No, you're not accepting it! Oh, you bugger. So we're going to be late now because of that. There we go. Oh, that was typical. Didn't want to accept it back there. No, it's only but one bloody door. Weird thing. Very funny game sometimes. Right, that's going to penalise us a bit. Let's see how many points we got from that. Because we'll be late, classed as late. Pro in a sec. It's not doing quite yet though. Still going for the 10. Right, signal down, but the cautious signal is on still, so but it is fixed. Distance signal. Take the corner very slowly anyway. 15 miles per hour, so easily able to brake if we need to. Which hopefully we don't have to do that. No, clear signal, so we're happy enough to keep going. Along. 37 coming up with fully loaded with China clay, I notice. It is the China clay line, so oh, he's thrashing a bit. So we have the signal ahead on for the other side of the station. I think this was Sabreeze Station, I believe. I'm not too sure. Anyone in the local area might know what this platform used to be, where this station is here. I know that's Sabreeze Depot behind us. Because we went through this red light, we should have gone backwards there, because there's the depot. But Apart from that, we would have got the token then for to go along this single track bit of line. It's interesting seeing the line running between, like, you've got stream one side and the stream the other. It's quite weird. Seeing the line just running right through the middle. Very weird. Right, we go up to 30 now. So we'll make do with that. So we're going to be arriving at the next station on time, according to our time ETA. As long as we keep going as we are, just about getting on time. Don't want to speed though, don't want to lose points for the fun of it. We have already lost 20 points for being late to power station. Crossing. Wonder if this used to be a station by here as well. Or was it used to be a crossing keeper's hat there? Should really look up about the information of the line before doing a video of this. Right, as you can see, the gradient is going to be rising in a bit. So, we'll need to start accelerating to go with it. Here we go. So, one in 70. On. One in 40. Christ, this is a steep gradient. It's a very steep gradient. You wouldn't want to be stuck carrying a very heavy load up here. Of course, the China clay trains take the load of the the China clay load all the way down here, don't they? So, quite interesting. Thanks. I always love to go and see the China clay trains running around these areas. But it's something to marvel at. And the line, the branch line goes all the way down to the docks for it to go along from Lostwithiel. It'd be interesting to see it go down there. It's beautiful going along the riverbanks, all the way down to the docks. The only thing is, a bit of a shame this line didn't do. They didn't keep it extending all the way up to Newquay, because it'd be so nice if they ran this all the way to Newquay. Like, because, you know, this is the Newquay branch now, and added Newquay in, like, in the prototypical years of his now. Or even a bit more modern if it needs to. So, yeah, interest now, it never got a bit further on from the where the China clay gets put on. No, they just stopped it then. Crossing over the bridge again. Just crossing over rivers, really. And we've got to go under a viaduct in a bit, and I believe in that footpath as well, because it used to be an old line originally. It might be a tram line. But there's an old viaduct that's going to be coming up in a bit, and I'm pretty sure I remember. I remember seeing it. It was something I was watching, and it showed you, like, walks, nice railway walks and stuff like that, and it shows you on there. talking about railway works, I've recently got a book I got bought for Christmas, railway works, so I've been enjoying doing them lately, going on these walks around my local area, with the book. Really good, actually. There's the viaduct, you can just see it now, peering over past the house. There we go. Said there was a viaduct. An interesting stone viaduct. But yeah, as I was saying, I've been going on like a couple of railway walks. You know, here is January, the month where everyone likes to go and make themselves a bit healthier. And so I've been enjoying going on these walks. I know it's been a bit cold on the weather-wise lately, but yeah, it's not so bad. You wrap up warm, you'll be alright. And yeah, I went on one last Saturday. I fancied it, but I never really done it. And yeah, went with the book and did it, and it was good and enjoyable. I'll just be doing a few more now. I can see me doing it. You know, they're great fun. But yeah, if I had the book here, I would actually plug it, because it's a very good book to read, and it's like, it tells you a bit of history of the line, and you know, bits of the history of the line, and it tells you what's it like today, and what's it like the walking, how you walk it, and the gradients, and everything. And it's really good. You know, you can work out, oh, like this has a heavy gradient, and this, that, and the other. I'd have plugged it for you all, for you to go and buy it. But yeah, interesting little Christmas present I got, and yeah, I've been greatly appreciating it. I can see me going using that and planning like little trips away somewhere around Britain. I may even put like a little point where I can go along some of these railway walks in a different area and just see the different regions. Like here, it's, you know, it's Great Western Territory, me living here in South Wales, but while saying that, the line I walked on recently was an Allen WR route, so I suppose it's not all Great Western, but I think the next one for this weekend will be Great Western now. But yeah, there's 15 coming up in a sec, so we'll just back off on the acceleration and let us coast away, coast our way up this bank. Let the bank take the strain. Breaking on. That's an amber signal as well. But these are fixed signals, so fixed distance. Let's stop any time for the 15 year. It's gonna be tight! Yeah, got it in time. Hopefully we can have a clear signal in a sec. We'll see in a bit. No, red. So yeah, that's light juddering there. That cleared for us now. So we'll put a bit of acceleration on. Oh god, I'm getting tired, eh? Right, signal box I can see just ahead. So we nearly finished this whole scenario. Quite a good scenario to be fair. Enjoyable and no drama at the moment. Touching wood, won't have drama at all on this one. Goes up to 35 in a bit. Cross over some points. Go to the yard for the China clay. Cross over our points ourselves. Price speed limit. Just speed it up a little. Don't want to go too slow. But you can see the buffer stops coming up after this. Of course, as the line continues on up to Newquay, but they just didn't put it on, which is a shame. They should have put it on. It would be, you know, it wouldn't be all just freight then. It'd be a bit more passenger run, a decent passenger run. Right, let's put the brakes on now. This station half looks like it used to be quite an important junction originally. Just the way the lines split off the platforms and the island. While braking. That'll do us. So there we go. That's pretty much it for this video. Oh. So, actually open the doors and let the passengers on. Let's try and find a nice place to look. Okay. Well, that's pretty much it. I hope you enjoyed that. If so, don't forget to put a little like at the bottom of the video. Also put a little comment down below if you any suggestions of scenarios or routes you want me to try out. And yeah, that's pretty much it. If you watched this and enjoyed it and like to watch or may have watched other ones beforehand and been watching, come again to watch another one, why don't you push that plus button at the bottom of the video and subscribe to this channel. Much appreciated, and join this lovely community that we have here. You can follow me on Facebook and Twitter. The link is down below in the description. There we go. Got 250 from there, so another 980 points. This is well done. A scenario completed, well done. You have completed the scenario successfully. So yeah, pretty much it. And don't forget, Monday we'll be back with Motorsport Manager. Let's go and check me out then. Motorsport Manager on the Monday. We'll be trucking for Europe on Wednesday on Euro Truck Simulator. And back on Train Simulator 2017 next Friday. Well, I hope you've enjoyed that. Until next time, bye for now.